Shotgun formation for Jimmy Bryant. He's looking to pass here. Going for the first down to a wide open receiver. Jesse Gutierrez again. And Gutierrez will get the first down on that play. Three on the previous play. Bryant will look to throw again. Swing pass for Gregory Thomas.
Oh, yes, he got it.
And Thomas will get the first, I believe, because that was a gain of 18. Line after a 4-yard run by Gregory Thomas. It's DJ. Touchdown, Sam Hebron. That is his seventh career touchdown against Washington. He didn't score in last year's matchup, but Sam Hebron 48-12. And he also, this is his eighth homecoming touchdown. He won the game against Fairfax 29-0. Here's the kick. High. It's good. We got a minute. Third and six, 5 yards of loss on the false start. Maria is a player coming in.
Whoa,
almost tipped. I believe it was either Thorpe or Josh Marshall. It was Marshall that got a hand up.
Josh Marshall got it.
He only 3 yards. DJ still going. Washington appeared to have had him for a loss.
Still going. That was a great pivot. Yeah, the guy blocked him, he just pivoted around and kept throwing his luck. He got a good throw, and then something was a lot. Still a game.
It's a handoff to somebody. It's a touchdown. We couldn't tell who it was. It was Jesse Gutierrez, of all people. That's his third touchdown run. I couldn't even keep up with him from my camera, but it was plus Jesse Gutierrez, 15 yards, and now it's 16-0 for the moment. Sam Reeder with the lead. Gaining 15 yards. Murillo's looking to get more than 15 here.
Whoa!
He's forced out of the pocket, and down goes Murillo.
Now we play against that.
First one, I think that's Trevor Thorpe. Also in there was number 99, Jacob Allen. So three nines were in there. Bryant sneaking it. Close, but I believe he may have picked it up. Yeah, they're giving it to him. First and 10 for Sam Hebron. Previous play was a 4-yard run by Thomas. It's a sweep to Palacios again. And Palacios dives fader. Touchdown, Sam Hebron. And it's Pete Palacios' second touchdown of the season. His first was a 54-yard touchdown reception in the 36-13 on the block. That's his first touchdown run on the varsity level. They already clinched the playoff spot by beating Bosco Tech 2 weeks ago. They're coming off a bye. DJ Santiago, touchdown Pirates again. That's touchdown number 36 for DJ this year, matching his jersey number, his second of the day, and 12th of the season, and it's 30-7, Sam Hebron.
That was exactly 5
to Jose Wita. They run the option. There's the pitch. It's dropped. I think one of Sam Hebron's players pounced on it like a cheetah. It was Christian Gonzalez recovering the fumble. Not an untimely turnover in the case of the Generals, and the Pirates have a chance to put up another touchdown on the board.
Pirates have been shooting an overload line.
It's Reverend Thomas. Let's see if he can get his woman in the score sheet, and he will. Touchdown, Pirates.
Well, you see, Mike
decided
to punch that run. He has an overload on the right side. That's where he has an unusual number of linemen instead of the usual guard tackle in the tight end. He has like an extra tight end.
Kelly Jordan in 2003. It's Chris Alzeiter with his first game of the game, and he scores. That's Alzeiter's second or third touchdown this year. I know he had a touchdown against West Davis Prep. This one's from 9 yards. And certainly the Pirates now have 44-7 advantage. For Coach Walsh, congratulations. As the two teams shake hands, Washington finishes 4-6, possibly with an outside shot of making the Division II City Section playoffs, and they finish Marine League 0-5. Unfortunately for the Generals, it is their 23rd straight Marine League defeat, but they are showing signs of progress, of improvement with A.C. Causey, and hope that the 4 wins they got in the City Section will give them a Division II playoff spot. So any final thoughts, Pete?
No, I just think it's been a great year. It went by. I know the city.